straight king wake baked, so very eager to try this. Never heard anything about them, never really done any research on them, just saw it for $10 at Tackle Warehouse, got a Black Friday deal, so we gotta throw it in there, try it out. You really can't fish winter without one of these, so took advantage of the Tackle Warehouse deal that was going on. They're on sale for $20 from $25, $60 special, Huddleston. This is in the silver green, rate of fall 5. I don't really fish anything but rate of fall 5 because it's easier to bring up an overcut. I don't really like going heavy with the rate of fall 12. I mean, I've lost a lot of rate of fall 12s, getting snagged. This is in the yellow perch, again, rate of fall 5, 68. You know, you got that 6-inch profile with that 8-inch tail on there. It's gonna move and disperse a lot of water. And I picked up one of these Jackal Mikey Jr. It's a floating, it's another wake bait. It's pretty cool. I think it's on perch pattern. Not sure if this says it, but I'm pretty sure this is perch. That perch pattern. If I can. So, a lot of swim baits, wake baits, a lot of big baits I ordered. And I'm sure everybody's familiar with these. S-Wave 120. This is in the I Know It color. Picked another one up in the gill, the bluegill color. Another 120. The first one I lost, hung up on a stump. Then I picked up a couple of these little custom leech by Kitech for drop shotting. I seen them, I was like, why not give them a try in that morning dawn color? Nice clear lake color for some smallmouth. Just that clear water. Get rid of that. I don't know if that's everything in here that's supposed to be in here. Nope, some more baits picked up. Got some more spin tricks by Bastrix. Fat Minnows. These are in the trout color, rainbow trout. I got a couple rainbow trout swim jigs, so should pair up nice with that. Now, on to the big stuff. I'm sick and tired of my old Planos falling apart, breaking, getting water in them. And finally decided to spend the money instead of keep throwing layers out. Finally decided to spend the money, the big bucks, on the good box. Watertight. Tell you what, they say you can drive over these things with your truck and you just can't destroy them. So I picked up some Bass Mafia boxes. This is the deep crank box. So things are pretty sick. Nice water seal, nice thick gasket. I'm gonna end up putting the liner up top here so I don't have to have that problem with things jumping over. I'm gonna end up putting the bullfrog protectors in there for the water. Take out the condensation. Picked up one of them. Picked up a 3700 deep for some of my swim baits, for my Huddlestons and stuff. So another good box. And we got a little straggler. We got them in the black color, the little leech. So little drop shot Kitex. And picked up, they have a terminal one that's labeled terminal coffin, but I don't like those little compartments and stuff that they had. It takes up too much room, so I figured I'd just go with this one here. And like I said, I'm gonna put the mesh in so I don't have to worry about the hooks jumping over or nothing. And this to me is laid out a lot better, and I'm gonna be able to set it up how I want to, whether it's gonna be, you know, weights and hooks, then, like, you know, shaky heads and punch stops and drop shot hooks over here, so however I want. So that's why I went with this over the terminal coffin. But yeah, that's it for this box. Done. Gonna just interrupt the Tackle Warehouse and Boxes for a split second here for a little mail call from a buddy of mine, Tom Wren. Makes these custom wake baits. These things are sick. They are sick. I'll tell you that. He does a great job. Does a real good job on these things. This is a sick color. Just ordered another one from him, so should be getting that in the mail pretty soon. And he also sent with that, he sent this pretty sick sticker right there. I can put on one of my boxes, probably my swim bait box. So thanks, Tom. I'll leave a link to his Facebook page down in the description below if you guys want to like check him out and order some of his baits from him. He does a real good job. So he's a real great guy. So next up, we're going to do one more mail call, and then we'll finish the Tackle Warehouse. So I already opened this up real quick just to check it out, see what it was, because it's I forgot I even ordered these things. These are from Major League Lures. I ended up ordering some boom shads. I got them in this crazy color right there. So I'm very interested to try these out. These are in the Spring Craw 5-inch. And then I picked up some 7-inch. Got some 7-inch in the, what's this, the Pearl IU. It's pretty sick beats right there. Tell you what, they look like they have a lot of action on them. So that's going to be great. So hopefully I don't have to dip these in some boiling water to soften the tails, because they already look like they have plenty of action. I got a couple more big boxes, but I want to jump to one of the small ones right for now. So we got this little guy. Well, paper tells you what's inside. Don't need that. Don't need that. All right, we got some Jacko by Jackal. Some little deep divers right here. Sick looking little baits. Oh, this is in a Silver Shiner. Great looking little bait right there. They're thin sided, so they got that tight wobble in the water. So that's really something there. Perfect little cold water bait right here. This one is in the Muddy Shad, Teal Muddy Shad. And then we have one in the Ghost IU. Another one in. I already have this color, but I broke the bill on it, so I just ordered another one. This is in the Crawfish. Then we got, I don't even know how to pronounce this, Wakasagi, I believe. Ghost Wakasagi. Then we have it in the Bluegill. Sick looking bait right there. This little Bluegill imitation. And these dive, I believe, 5 to 8. 3/8 ounce. I don't think it says, but I'm pretty sure it's, they don't run that deep. They're like anywhere from 5 to 8 to maybe 10 feet. Then, you know, I picked up a Spro. See a lot of guys catching some nice sized fish on this little 6-inch Spro. This is in the, I believe, the Silver Heron. I don't know if it even says it, but this is a slow sink. Not sure on the color, but I'm pretty sure it's Silver Heron. And then I picked up a 6-inch. Speed Glide. Sick looking bait. It's in the, I believe this is the Bluegill. Yeah, Bluegill Fire. So that's a really sick looking bait right there. That's it for this box here. So. Get rid of this one right here. Got a bunch of tackle, a bunch of gear. I got a bunch more boxes. I got this box, and I got 1, 2, 3, 4 more boxes right here to undo, and I still have 3 more in the mail on the way. but I couldn't wait for those. I got a little impatient. I just want to hurry up and do this video so I can put all my tackle away so the wife don't kill me, because it's taking over her kitchen. So this is the smart thing to do, I hope. Or maybe not. Maybe she'll just kill me still. Who knows? No, I'm just kidding. But all right, I ordered a bunch of cranks, some deep diving cranks, some 1.5s. They go up to 8 feet. It's not really that deep, you know. It's still kind of shallow for me. But I ordered a bunch and needed some new ones. I kind of ruined my old ones. Like I said, that's why I ordered the Bass Mafia boxes, because I got sick of tackle getting ruined. I ruined probably well over $300-$400 of tackle this year just from water getting in my boxes in the boat. Just carelessness, and it's just, I don't even want to talk about it. But got this guy right here, Sexy Shad. Picked up this guy right here. This isn't that bluegill, neon bluegill. Again, these are flat sided too, so these are great cold water baits because they have that tight action, that tight wobble. This isn't that Sexy Shad, the summer Sexy Shad. Then we got it in the chartreuse perch. Then we got it in the chartreuse blackback. Then I picked up a little Sexy Dog Junior. Picked it up in the bluegill pattern. It's kind of translucent. Great little topwater bait. One of my go-to topwaters. That bait right there. Then we got it in the blue gizzard. Another one of those cranks. So it's translucent, pretty much for clear water. When I go to like a clear water place, and those fish are really finicky. So, and I picked up the Warden S-Waver. This is the 168 S-Waver. Another glide bait. They make a really killer glide bait, River to Sea. Then I heard all the hype about these right here. So I went, I picked up two packages. I picked one up in white with like a silver fleck in there, the Biospawn Biocraw. So yeah, I picked it up in the white color right here. This is the white silver fleck. So that's a good bait to throw on a bed just so I can see it. That white sticks out really well in the water. Then I picked up some green pumpkin. Yeah, I give them a go, see how I like them. You know, they kind of look really finessey for a craw. A lot different from the bunch of craws that I use. Well, I had to pick up one of my go-to drop shot baits, my all-around just get it done bait when the bite is tough, and that's these Power Team tubes right here. These food chain tubes are just, in this color right here, the green pumpkin copper fleck, I just kill it, just crush it with this thing. Whenever that bite is tough, I just throw one of these on, and it's game on. Of course, on the Takawero sticker right there. Box done.